Welcome to this Zentangle Quickie. My name is Heather Hartwick Gladden. I'm a certified Zentangle teacher. And today we're going to take a look at the Tangle Schoggi, and I hope I'm pronouncing that right, by CZT Annett Ruempler. So this Tangle was brought to my attention on our last Tangle Time session. Somebody had added it in to their panel. We were doing Glick Jam, and I was like, oh, that's an interesting one. What is it? I'm like, well, hey, we're going to have to do it. So, all right, so this is rather neat. Makes me think of a couple of existing tangles, and I think I'm going to do it on the diagonal because that's the way I'm holding it. So this starts off with two, you know, kind of curvy lines, however you want them to be. Let's see if I can just there. And, you know, kind of aura-ing and then, you know, come together at the top, like so. And then at the bottom, you can, you know, just, whoops, cap it off somehow. Then we're going to do an orb behind this and come up a little ways, just a tiny bit from the base of this, and hollow-bowing behind. So if you don't know what hollow-bow is, it's a technique and it's a tangle, and it's Molly's last name, the daughter of Maria, of the Zentangle HQ. And it's really the art of drawing behind. So as you saw, so I started here, came around, picked up my pen, traveled it over as if I was, as if I was drawing it, and then put the pen down on the other side and continue on my merry way. And then, you know, bringing it back along here as if I was, you know, having it meet up. So, and that's really what it is. And it doesn't have to be perfect. Nothing has to be perfect, especially in Zentangle. All right. Then we're going to use the rounding technique. So on, you know, the base of this, you know, just kind of just like that, you know, and however it moves you to do. I was looking. Here's what I was looking for. I just went back to look. Like some of them, you know, could be a little elongated like this. And I was thinking, do I want to smooth this kind of bump out so that, you know, so it's not, there's not like a harsh bump. It's up to you. And you can take a look at, in the description section, the For More Inspiration link, and take a look at Annett's work. And then you can decide for yourself. All right, then we're gonna aura all of this. So this makes me think of diva dance. And if you've not tried the Tangle Diva Dance, it kind of comes in a number of ways to do it. But, you know, it's like you have a line, and sometimes it's a spiral, that's diva dance rock and roll. There's other ones that, you know, where it's just a line, and you add, it's not necessarily a bump like this, but it's a bump, and then you go around and you aura, you know, everything with that new piece of contour, that new bump, and then you add another bump, and then you kind of keep going, alternating, and that makes me think, this makes me think of that tangle. In this respect, it's, like I said, it's just a ginormous bump. And then also makes me think of, and I don't know when Annett put this one out, but it also makes me think of like the newish tangle from Zentangle called Mythograph, which, you know, it has, and that's more of this part, the auraing up. And then let me tell you the two part in a moment. So then we're going to do a similar thing. We're going to, but this time it's not really doing an orb like this that looks like one thing. This, we're going to just do like a couple of squashed orbs, you know, like ovaly type shapes on the side. And they can, you know, you can have them positioned however you wish. Which is nice, because when it just comes out like, oh, well, that's not exactly what I intended, but all right, then it's okay. And I went back to look at Annette's work, and she had some that, where this orb was kind of, she had like maybe more of a dip in here, and it was down a little bit further. So it doesn't have to be like where these things meet up or anything, wherever you want them. And it's going to depend on, well, on, you know, how long this is, and just what you feel like doing, which is what's cool. And then I'll remember what I was going to say. And two. Oh, yeah. The Tangle Gorgeous from Zentangle. You know, this part, the auraing and adding thickness again. And it's similar to the Diva Dance, kind of a variation, you know, on that theme. All right. So then we're going to do the same thing coming from this base. And I noticed that she kind of doesn't come right from the tip. She kind of leaves this sort of like a stem. But now we're auraing all of this. My pen is being a little temperamental. Now it's behaving. All right, and then we'll do another. Again, I think it's really good just to take a look at what Annette did, so that way, well, besides, it'll give you really great ideas. So what's neat about this is it kind of looks like a, you know, some kind of a seed pod. And what a nice idea, because we've got a lot of leafy type of tangles, a lot of flowery type of tangles, you know, different viney type of tangles. So why not? Okay, and then again, yep, we're gonna aura that whole thing. And then we'll do some shading. Oh, no, I'm sorry, there's one more little step. That's essentially it. She had a little, it was just like a little ball up at the top. I don't know if it was just kind of tying things together. You can barely see it in the, in, I know in the, like the tip of mine, just, and even in Annette's. But that's it. So here's some shading ideas. First, you find your pencil. I know, it's like, you know, I know I should have it handy right here, don't I? I do. Do I have it handy? No. Well, I did, and then it disappeared. No, it blended into this sea of pens and markers that I happen to have on my desk. Well, isn't that neat? Okay, well, I have a substitute. Okay. So, I'm just going to add some right here where things can, where the, you know, everything kind of converges there. And then let's do like right here, kind of just doing where the bends are. But then because we have some things going out at different angles, that's kind of neat. So I wanted to maybe take advantage of that. Okay, so we got the base. Some right there, and I seem to have a lot on this tortillon. Add some there. Mm-hmm. That looks kind of cool. I kind of like the idea of having them at somewhat either like different lengths, you know, of how far the graphite goes. so that it just kind of, it looks, I don't know, I just think that that looks neat. Yeah. And then at the tip, of course, where everything converges. We knock those out first. And then, you know, just because there's needs to be something there. Oh, that looks neat. And that's what, you know, that's what's kind of fun is just look and say, oh, I think it needs something here. And then just do it. Now, of course, in here, I'm going to put some graphite on either side of this because it's kind of, you know, that orb is like behind it or something. In my mind, it is. Whether it really is or not, that remains to be seen. And then just some, I'm using what's left on my tortillon, just to add a little dimension to these little pods. Neat. Neat. We don't know what it's a pod of, but because it's a, because it's non-representational. It's just, you know, it just is what it is. Oh, you know, this, I'm feeling like this needs to have a little bit more darkness on the one side. Just for some distinction. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. All right, very cool. Well, neat. Well, I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, I would love to have you click like. And if you liked it enough to see more, I'd love it if you become a subscriber to the channel. I mentioned the description section for Annett Step Out. I always do my own version, and so that will be there as well. I have links to, well, let me mention it now. If you'd like to hang out with a bunch of amazing tanglers, Tangle Addicts, we call ourselves, we'd love to have you. And there's a link to our private Facebook group. So know that there are like 3 questions to gain entry. And that's it. And then just come, participate, share your work, you know, gush over everybody else's. That's what we like to do best. But we have a lot of fun. It's really great. I also do classes, so there's a link to my website as well as my Facebook page where you can you know, get updates if you follow me on Facebook. There's some other places that I also post the classes, like Eventbrite and Meetup.com. So there's links there for those as well. And you can also sign up for, you know, put your email address in for my blog. One day I'll get to announcing classes on my blog, but until then, there are other ways to follow me. What I do post on my blog are things like this, a daily tangle, and replays, recaps from the classes that we do, the free ones. I do have a lot of them that are free. I do have a few that are paid, and also I have a club membership. So if, you know, you come on and you try some classes for free, and you think you'll take at least one class a month, it's well worth it because it's essentially 3 classes. And at the time of this recording, just to let you know, take a look. The price is going to go up some point soon, as soon as I get off of my duff and and make some things happen, because I did add a class. So it's essentially all access. So to the online classes. So I just need to do it, and I will make it, whatever announcement I make, I'll give at least a month's notice. So anyway, I just want to share that here because I know that there are some that have been sort of debating, but just know I'll at least give that, and I'll make an announcement here. Oh, I should do one of those community, what, I forget what their kind of thing. I don't know, a community thing or a short or something. I don't know. Anyway, I just want to let you know. So with that, thanks so much for watching. And I wish you happy tangling.